Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. When you conduct research about a group of people, it's rarely possible to collect data from every person in that group. Instead, you select a sample. The sample is the group of individuals who will actually participate in the research. So, question is, what is sampling? Sampling means selecting a particular group or sample to represent the entire population. To draw valid conclusions from your results, you have to carefully decide how you will select a sample that is representative of the group as a whole. 1. Probability sampling. It involves random selection, allowing you to make strong statistical inferences about the whole group. 2. Nonprobability sampling. It involves non-random selection based on convenience or other criteria, allowing you to easily collect data. Okay, so, the important question is, why are samples used in research? Samples are used to make inferences about populations. Samples are easier to collect data from because they are practical, cost-effective, convenient, and manageable. Now, we need to understand the both terms. 1. What is probability sampling? Probability sampling means that every member of the target population has a known chance of being included in the sample. Probability sampling methods include simple random sampling, systematic sampling, stratified sampling, and cluster sampling. 1. Simple random sampling. In a simple random sample, every member of the population has an equal chance of being selected. Your sampling frame should include the whole population. To conduct this type of sampling, you can use tools like random number generators or other techniques that are based entirely on chance. 2. Systematic sampling. Systematic sampling is similar to simple random sampling, but it is usually slightly easier to conduct. Every member of the population is listed with a number, but instead of randomly generating numbers, individuals are chosen at regular intervals. 3. Stratified sampling. Stratified sampling involves dividing the population into subpopulations that may differ in important ways. It allows you to draw more precise conclusions by ensuring that every subgroup is properly represented in the sample. 4. Cluster sampling. Cluster sampling also involves dividing the population into subgroups, but each subgroup should have similar characteristics to the whole sample. Instead of sampling individuals from each subgroup, you randomly select entire subgroups. What is nonprobability sampling? In nonprobability sampling, the sample is selected based on non-random criteria, and not every member of the population has a chance of being included. Common non-probability sampling methods include convenience sampling, voluntary response sampling, purposive sampling, snowball sampling, and quota sampling. 1. Convenience sampling. A convenience sample simply includes the individuals who happen to be most accessible to the researcher. This is an easy and inexpensive way to gather initial data, but there is no way to tell if the sample is representative of the population. 2. Voluntary response sampling. Similar to a convenience sample, a voluntary response sample is mainly based on ease of access. Instead of the researcher choosing participants and directly contacting them, people volunteer themselves, for example, by responding to a public online survey. 3. Purposive sampling. This type of sampling, also known as judgment sampling, involves the researcher using their expertise to select a sample that is most useful to the purposes of the research. 4. Snowball sampling. If the population is hard to access, snowball sampling can be used to recruit participants via other participants. The number of people you have access to snowballs as you get in contact with more people. The significant differences between probability and non-probability sampling. 1. Meaning, the sampling technique, in which the subjects of the population get an equal opportunity to be selected as a representative sample, is known as probability sampling, a sampling method in which it is not known that which individual from the population will be chosen as a sample, is called non-probability sampling. 2. Alternately known as, the basis of probability sampling is randomization or chance, so it is also known as random sampling. On the contrary, In nonprobability sampling, randomization technique is not applied for selecting a sample, hence it is considered as non-random sampling. 3. Basis of selection. In probability sampling, the sampler chooses the representative to be part of the sample randomly, whereas, in nonprobability sampling, the subject is chosen arbitrarily. 4. Opportunity of selection. The chances of selection in probability sampling are fixed and known, as opposed to nonprobability sampling. The selection probability is zero. For example, it is neither specified nor known. 5. Research. Probability sampling is used when the research is conclusive in nature. On the other hand, when the research is exploratory, nonprobability sampling should be used. 6. Result. The results generated by probability sampling are free from bias, while the results of nonprobability sampling are more or less biased. 7. Hypothesis. Probability sampling test hypothesis, but nonprobability sampling generates it. Conclusion. While probability sampling is based on the principle of randomization, where every entity gets a fair chance to be a part of the sample, nonprobability sampling relies on the assumption that the characteristics are evenly distributed within the population, which make the sampler believe that any sample so selected would represent the whole population and the results drawn would be accurate. Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.